In this tutorial, we will learn about how to get started with AutoCAD Web App. Before that, anyone will ask why use AutoCAD Web App. So, I have some reasons for using it. First and very important reason is it is free. You don't have to purchase it. Then second will be if your work involves to view or check the drawings and make small changes or comments, then it is perfect for you. You don't have to purchase and install full version. Then third, I will say if you are at some other location where you have the computer and internet connection but don't have AutoCAD and you need to use AutoCAD, then also you can make use of AutoCAD web application. So these are some of my reasons to use AutoCAD web app, and I am sure there may be more. You can share your reasons in comment below. Before we start, I request you to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon to receive new video notifications every alternate Monday, Wednesday and Saturday. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. So to start web app, at first you will have to open your web browser. You can use Chrome or Firefox or any other you like. So here I am using Firefox. Then type here web.autocad.com and press enter. So it will open this page. If you have Autodesk ID, you can sign in from here. And if you don't have Autodesk ID, you can create here free account. So just click here on free account. So to create your free account, you will have to specify here your first name, then your last name, then email address. Then you will have to confirm that email address. Then you will have to create one password. So password should have at least one letter, one number, minimum 8 characters and at least 3 unique characters. Then once you filled all this data, you will have to tick here on I agree and click here on create account. Then it will send you verification email. You will have to open your email and check the email from Autodesk. And you will have to click on that link given in that email. So in this way you can create your account. So here I already have created one account. So I will directly sign in here. So just click here on sign in. Then specify your email address using which you have created account. So I will type here my email address. Then press enter. Then type your password. Again press enter. So here it has logged in and it has started AutoCAD web app. So here you will see that all commands and tools in the AutoCAD web app are free for everyone for an extended period. So this is the user interface of AutoCAD web app. So here you will see list of some sample drawings. And if you have created any drawings using this app, then those drawings will also be visible here. Then if you have some drawings on your PC which you want to see, then you will have to click here on upload, then browse the folder and select that drawing and click here on open. Then if you want to create here some folder, you can directly click here on new folder and create new folder. And if you want to create new drawing, you can create that new drawing from here. And if you have some drawings on your storage provider, such as Google Drive, OneDrive or others, then you can connect that account also by clicking here on add and by providing your login credentials. And you can directly open those drawings from those storage providers. So here I will show you how to create new drawing. So to create new drawing, click here on new drawing. Then specify name to your drawing. Suppose I want it to be trial 3. Then from here you will have to choose your template. So they have provided here metric template for mm, centimeter, meter and kilometer unit. Then imperial for feet and inches. And if you have some templates on your computer, you can click here on add drawing templates. And using this upload, you can upload those templates. So I will cancel it. Done. Then I will choose here metric. Click on create. So it will start a blank drawing. So here drawing is started. So here you will see the name of the app, AutoCAD Web and Mobile. Then here we have started drawing named as trial3.dwg is the extension of AutoCAD file. Then on the left side you have this object properties panel where it shows different properties using which it will create object, or if you already have some objects you can change their properties by using this panel. Then there are some more panels like layers, blocks, xrep and so on. Then here are draw commands, then some of the annotate command such as dimension, text. Then you can check dimension using this measure command. Then there are some modify commands such as move, copy, fillet, chamfer and so on. Then here is undo, redo, then zoom extend and zoom window. Then from here also you can change your layers. Then using this you can open this current drawing in desktop. Then this black area is actual drawing area. Then here is command line or command prompt. Then here is object snap settings. So you can choose your desired object snaps. And by clicking on it, you can turn it off or turn it on. If it is highlighted, that means it is on. Same way from here, you can control your object snap tracking, ortho mode and polar tracking. And you can choose your desired angle for polar tracking. And by clicking on these three lines, you can control visibility of these buttons. And if you want to view the coordinates also, just click here, click outside. So here coordinate is shown. If you don't want to view them, just click here, click on coordinate. So here those are hidden. So this is the user interface of web app. Suppose we will just try creating some simple object. Suppose we will start with some layer. For that, click here on layers, then click here on create layer, then give name to your layer, suppose it is center. Then to change color, click here and choose your desired color. Then to change line type, click here and here is center line type. Okay, actually I have changed line type for this zero layer. So for this zero layer, I want continuous only. So I will click here on continuous. Then click here on center and then change your line type to center. Whichever layer is selected, that becomes current also. So whatever object you will create will be created on that layer. Then suppose I want to create one center line. So click here on draw and click here on line. Then specify first point. So here dynamic input is not there. So you will have to read any message from this command prompt area. So here specify first point. So just click there. Then to make ortho mode on, click here on ortho. Take your cursor on this side. Then you can specify here length. Suppose length is 500. Press enter. Then again press enter to stop line command. Then from here you can zoom extend. And using middle mouse button you can zoom minus. If you rotate your middle mouse button towards you, then it will be zoom minus. And if you rotate your middle mouse button towards monitor, then it will be zoom plus. Suppose I want to create one more line, so you can also type here. So here I have typed L for line, then press enter, then specify first point, take your cursor below, click and press enter. Then suppose I want to create offset, for that click here on modify, click here on offset. Then here you will have to specify offset distance. Suppose it is 300, enter. Then select object offset, take your cursor on this side and click. Then press escape to stop offset command. Then here center lines are not properly visible, so to increase the gap, type LTS. For line type scale, press enter, then enter new line type scale factor, suppose it is 5, enter. So I will increase it further, again press enter to repeat last command, suppose I will make it 10, enter. So here center lines are properly visible. Then suppose I want to create one circle here on zero layer. So just click here, click on zero, so that layer will become current. Suppose I want to change color for this zero layer, so click here, click on other color. Then to create circle, you can click here or also type C. Suppose I will click here. Then take your cursor here. Here it is taking that intersection object snap automatically, because your object snap is turned on. So click here, take your cursor away, then specify radius, suppose it is 75, enter. Then again enter to repeat last command. If you want to use other option, you will have to click here on those options. So I want to create using center point only, so I will directly click here, take your cursor away, suppose radius is 40, enter. Then if you don't want to see this panel, by clicking here on that panel, you can hide it temporary. And if you want to bring that panel back, then again you will have to click here on any one button, so it will come back. Suppose I want to keep it off. Then suppose I want to create one line here. For that again I will type L for line, press enter. Then I want to create tangent line. So to select manual object snap, just right click, take your cursor to snap override and click here on tangent. Then click here on this circle, again right click, snap override, tangent, and click. Then you can also right click and confirm to cancel the line command. Again right click to repeat last command. Again right click, snap override, tangent, click, right click, snap override, tangent, click, and right click, confirm. So here this object is created. Then suppose I want to remove this portion, so for that you will have to use trim command. So again click here, click on modify and click here on trim. Then take your cursor on the object you want to remove. So just click on the object you want to remove. So those objects will be removed. Then right click and confirm. So in this way this object is created. Then to apply dimensions, again click here, click on annotate, click on dimension. Then click on this endpoint and this endpoint, take your cursor below and click. So here dimension is added. Same way, suppose I want to add this radius, so click and click. Same way on this circle, click, click. And if you want to increase the size of these dimensions, before that press escape. Click here on property, then select these dimensions. You can also use crossing window. Then from here you can choose different dimension style. If you take higher number dimension style, size will increase. And if you take lower value dimension style, size will decrease. Suppose I will take it 7, then press escape. So here this drawing is created. And if you want to resize this line, just click here on this line, click on this blue grip, take your cursor on this side, click. Press escape, same way here, click, click, take it inside, click, press escape. You can also double click middle mouse button for zoom extent, and you can hide this by clicking here. So in this way this drawing is ready. Then if you want to create PDF from this drawing, so you can directly click here on plot to PDF. Then choose your paper size. Suppose I want ISO A4 landscape, choose here landscape and click here on plot to PDF. So it will generate that PDF and it will give message here once it is done. So here PDF is ready. Just click here on download PDF. So here it is downloading the PDF and here PDF is ready. So in this way you can create PDF also. And you can save that drawing by clicking here on save. So it will save that drawing. And if you want to go back to that original interface, just click here on AutoCAD Web and Mobile. So here you will see that trial 3 new drawing has been added. And if you want to download this drawing, just click here. So from here you can open it, rename it, move it, duplicate, delete, or download. So just click here on download. So here that download is completed. So in this way you can download that drawing on your PC also. So in this way you can use this AutoCAD web app. And if you want more detailed tutorial on this AutoCAD web app, then let me know in the comments below so that I will make them for you. Please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.